Hi folks, Will from MinIO here with a how-to on listing MinIO buckets with .NET. In this video, we're going to be using .NET version 6. We're going to be connecting to our play.min.io sandbox, and we're going to be using all of this out of Visual Studio 2022. Let's take a look at our environment. So here's our Visual Studio environment. I've already imported the MinIO packages using NuGet. And what I'm doing here is I'm really just running a simple main method that connects to play.min.io and then calls this asynchronous run method. Now, since MinIO is RESTful, we've actually built our .NET SDK to be almost entirely asynchronous in nature. So that's going to mean a lot of asyncs and a lot of awaits while you're actually working with this, but it really is the best way to handle a RESTful interface via .NET. By the way, all these methods that we're going to be looking at will always have this implied ability to use a cancellation token. So you can actually run all these tasks in parallel if you're uploading stuff and downloading stuff. You can actually run all of these in parallel and still have a really clean way to manage any failures with grace. So all that aside, this is a very simple example. I'm just going to be doing a list buckets command. And the actual method name is list buckets async, and it takes a cancellation token if you want to actually use one. Since I'm only doing this one task, I'm not going to use a cancellation token. So what I'm doing here is I've got this MinIO client that I've already connected to play.min.io, and I'm calling list buckets async on it. I'm going to await the result of that. Now, the result of this is going to be a list that has a bunch of buckets in it, wrapped in a task. And what I'm going to do is for each bucket in there, I am going to write out the bucket name and then the bucket creation date and time. And that's really all that I'm doing. It's very simple. There's lots of different exceptions that can arise from this. Again, I'm handling all my exceptions in the main method just to not clutter up what the example code that I'm here to show you. But some various exceptions that you might get, you may get an invalid bucket name, or you may get a connection exception, you may get an error response or an internal client. There's lots of different exceptions that you might need to handle. Take a look at our documentation on that. Probably you got to this video from our documentation, but please take a look at the documentation and see what you can see around what exceptions may come back. There's lots of different ones. So all I'm going to do now with this is I'm going to go ahead and build it and run it. So I'm going to do my .NET build. There we go. No warnings, no errors, so we're good to go. And I'm going to do a .NET.run, and that's it. So there we go. There are all of the buckets that are available to us out on play.min.io. Boy, there's a lot of them. A lot of different folks playing around with play.min.io. I should mention at this stage that play.min.io often gets deleted. Everything that gets put up there gets deleted on a regular basis. It is not used for anything other than this sort of just basic example code that you want to work with. And that's going to be our example for the day, and that's going to be our entire how-to on how to list buckets using our .NET client API. If you'd like to connect with us, you can connect with us with any of the methods shown here on your screen. You can also contact us directly on minio.slack.com, or you can always just leave a comment here on the video. Thanks very much, and we'll see you for the next one.